welcome to the class. Today we are going to begin with a new chapter, that is lesson number 8, Marathas. Here we are going to study about Shivaji, footsteps of Shivaji, his administration and what all were his achievements. Okay, now we shall start studying one by one. In this lesson, the childhood of Shivaji, his ideals, the way he resisted Mughals and Bijapur army, establishment of Maratha kingdom and his administrative measures are explained. See, what we are going to study in this lesson, we are going to study about the childhood of Shivaji, how he fought and won against these Mughals and against the Bijapur army. Then we are going to study how they have established this Maratha kingdom and their administrative measures. Marathas were the ones who revolted against the Mughals in the Deccan region when Mughals were at their height of power in North India. See, Marathas, what happened is actually they were very much strongly disapproving these Mughals when the Mughals were strongly ruling, when the Mughals had the highest power in the northern part of this India. Shivaji was the founder of Maratha dynasty. So who was the founder of Maratha dynasty? Shivaji, he was the founder of Maratha dynasty.
After this, he won Rayagad
Afzal Khan to suppress Shivaji. See, as Shivaji was conquering or as he was winning one by one the places, this made whom? Sultan of Bijapur very angry. He got very much angry, and in the anger what he did, he sent his general Afzal Khan to suppress Shivaji. Afzal Khan wanted to kill Shivaji decisively, so he invited Shivaji under the pretext of reconciliation. Actually, what was the plan of Afzal Khan was, he thought he is going to kill Shivaji by misleading him. Decisively in the sense what? By misleading him. So Afzal Khan, he invited Shivaji in the pretext of reconciliation, means as if having any friendly relationship. Means Afzal Khan very misleadingly invited Shivaji in the name of friendly relation. With what intention? With the intention of killing Shivaji. Accepting this, Shivaji killed Afzal Khan with Vajranakhasi. How Shivaji killed? Shivaji, he killed Afzal Khan. With what weapon? With Vyagra Nakha. This means that tiger's claw, a weapon that he had made with him. Shivaji, actually he had hidden the claws of the tiger within him. So when he was invited, he killed Afzal Khan with this Vyagra Nakha. On learning these advancements of Shivaji, Aurangzeb sent his general for Deccan province, Shahista Khan, to curb him down. But clever Shivaji was able to defeat Shahista Khan. After knowing this, means knowing about this, Aurangzeb again, what he did, he sent the general of Deccan province, whose name is Shahista Khan, to hold back Shivaji. But what Shivaji did, he defeated Shahista Khan also. Shahista Khan had stayed at the palace of Pune to attack Shivaji. He could not get hold of Shivaji, even waiting for 2 long years. She actually, what had happened was, Shahista Khan, he was living in the fort of Pune for 2 long years. But the problem was that he could not hold out Shivaji. One night, Shivaji, in disguise, along with his soldiers, entered the living quarters of Shahista Khan and attacked him. See, one night, Shivaji, along with his army, what he did? He went to the fort where Shahista Khan stayed and went in the idea of defeating him. Khan somehow escaped the attack, but lost his thumb. In panic, Shahista Khan fled from Pune. Somehow, Shahista Khan, he saved himself from the attack, but his thumb was cut. But in his fear, what he did? He left from Pune and went back. This maddened Aurangzeb, so he sent a huge army under the leadership of Raja Jai Singh. Again, this success of Shivaji made Aurangzeb very angry. He got murdered. So what he did again? Aurangzeb, he sent a huge army under whose leadership? Under the leadership of Raja Jai Singh. Jai Singh defeated Shivaji and captured a few Maratha forts. Now what Jai Singh did? He defeated Shivaji and captured few of the Maratha forts. At the end, Jai Singh invited Shivaji to Delhi to come to have treaty with Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb arrested Shivaji on his arrival and kept him in the prison of Agra. After capturing few of the Maratha places, what Jai Singh did at the end, he invited Shivaji to Delhi to sign the treaty with Aurangzeb. But as soon as Shivaji entered to the Aurangzeb, Shivaji arrived, what Aurangzeb did? He arrested Shivaji and kept him in the prison of Agra. But Shivaji played a trick and escaped from In spite of keeping Shivaji in the jail, he played a trick. What was the trick played? Somehow he escaped and he reached back to his capital. Shivaji played a trick, got free himself from the jail or from the prison and went back to his capital. After that, he won the force that he had lost to the Mughals. After coming back to the capital, what he did? He won back those forts or those places which he had lost to the Mughals. He attacked Surat and ransacked huge wealth there from there. See, what Shivaji did? He attacked Surat and he caused lot of damages, huge damages. Shivaji, in that war, what he did? He caused huge damage and looted all the wealth from there. This was about the footsteps of Shivaji. Now, we are going to study about the coronation. Coronation of Shivaji. Coronation of Shivaji. In Rayagada, Shivaji was conferred with the title Chhatrapati. Coronation in the sense what? Actually, coronation of Shivaji means crowning ceremony of Shivaji was taken place. In Rayagada, what happened was Shivaji, he was given the title Chhatrapati and he was crowned as the king of Marathas in a lavish ceremony. In a lavish, in a very luxurious eye-seeing ceremony was being arranged there, and he was crowned, and also the title was given as Chhatrapati. Soon after coronation, Shivaji won Jinji, Bellur, and large area of Mysore province and received a heavy tribute. See, soon after crowning him, what Shivaji did? He won many of the places like Jinji, Velluru and large area of Mysore province, and also he received very heavy tribute. But Shivaji could not live long to witness the grandeur of the Marathas. After getting crowned and after he was titled as Chhatrapati, after winning these many places, what happened was Shivaji, he could not live for longer time. He could not see the success of these Marathas. He could not see that. It was not a success. It was a very much impressive success of Marathas, which Shivaji could not see. He could not see the style of Marathas. Shivaji died very soon. Now, we are going to study about the administration. Administration of Shivaji. Administration of Shivaji. There were 8 ministers called Ashtapradhanas to assist him in administrative matters. Totally, how many ministers were there? There were 8 ministers who were called as what? They were called as Ashtapradhanas, who used to guide him, who used to guide Shivaji in the administrative matters. The prime minister was called as Peshwa, means the one who was the prime minister then, he was called as Peshwa. After the death of Shivaji, a political crisis arose, but it was successfully solved by the Peshwas and smoothened the administration. What happened? After the death of Shivaji, soon after his death, political crisis started in the Marathas, but these Peshwas, they successfully solved the political crisis and smoothened the administration. From here onwards, the administration of Maratha provinces was taken over by the Peshwas. Soon after this, when they successfully handled this political crisis, from there what happened? These Peshwas, they look over the administration of the Maratha provinces. Balaji Vishwanath, Bajirao I and Balaji Bajirao are the important Peshwas who ruled Maratha kingdom. They have named a few of the important Peshwas who ruled Maratha kingdom. Who were those important Peshwas? They were Balaji Vishwanath, Bajirao I and Balaji. important Peshwas who ruled this Maratha kingdom. This is all about the Marathas. A very small lesson that is about Shivaji. Shivaji, where he was the founder of Maratha dynasty. He was born in Shivneri Durga near Pune, and then his father was Shivaji Bhosle, mother was Jijabai. This is about the Shivaji, and then we studied about the footsteps of Shivaji, coronation, that is crowning ceremony of Shivaji, and how was the administration of Shivaji taken over, and after the death, who took the administration of Maratha, that is Peshwas. This is all about the Marathas. I hope you people have followed this lesson. Thank you.